to try and please me. You never let me down before. Mm-hmm. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore. I would not leave you in times of trouble. We never could have come this far. I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, I'll take you just the way you are.
1977年6月、ビリーは音楽の殿堂カーネギーホールで3日間のコンサートを行った。チケットは全てソールドアウト。晴れの舞台で大きな成功を収めた。このコンサートはさらにビリーの運命を大きく変えた。プロデューサーフィル・ラモーンとの出会い、レイ・チャールズからマドンナまで幾多の名盤を手掛け、14回もグラミー賞を受賞している巨匠はビリーのアルバムで腕を振るうことになる。
We talked about what I thought about his music and the sound of Billy, and I felt very strong about the combination of his band and what happened between the band and himis what I thought was magic. And I, as much as I loved the records, because I listened to everything he had done, I felt that was missing. It's fortunate that I said that, because a very famous man, George Martin, he was also interviewing. And George had said something about great studio musicians, because it was very typical in those days to not use your band from the stage, unless you were a band, you know?They would have much preferred to use what they called professional musicians.
憧れのビートルズのプロデューサー、ジョージ・マーティン。しかし、ビリーはこの夢のような話を捨て、フィルとアルバムを作った。
Any of the recordings we ever did, did he, we ever make a track, meaning a background track, and then have him sing? Never did that. The atmosphere of those records are him.Banging at the piano loud, the drums playing, the energy. Because I was afraid to lose what I saw on stage, and I didn't want to have Liberty DeVito was the drummer, and I would go out there and I'd say, play harder. You don't play that soft on it. Well, I was always told, and when he made a record, he told me, he was always told to play softer. And I put physically the Billy at, looking right at Liberty.The bass player, Doug Stegmaier, right here.
プロデューサーフィル・ラモーンはまるで魔法のようにビリーのアイデアを最高の形にしてみせた。フィルはビリーとまさに二人三脚でアルバム作りをリードした。
I believe in instinct and the spirit of what the music brings.And there were many, many funny stories, you know, from what we called、before we ate, when we were really hungry, and either it was going to be pizza or Chinese food or something that would change the atmosphere, because I wouldn't let the band go out. Once they came to work, that was it. And I believe in that, you know, it's kind of you're part of the studio, the environment, and everything about it, because it's your home.And how do you make this comfortable? And so we got to be really good friends that way. And in between, I would play stuff, change stuff. He got to the point where he was so comfortable, which is unusual because the studio has a, you know, austere, it's like going to a palace. You know, it's a very strange place to make music in a way.
完成したアルバムからは、まずオープニングナンバーのムービンアウトがシングルカットされた。しかしこれはほとんど話題にならず、続くセカンドシングル素顔のままでの大ヒットがビリーとこのアルバムの名を永遠のものにした。ところが、実はビリーとバンドメンバーは素顔のままでが大嫌いだったという。
And so they put the second song out, Just the Way You Are, which was a struggle for us to make that record, because I believed in the song, but he was afraid it would be too middle of the road. He reluctantly played it for me, and I said, I really like this, and you know, the drummer was ready to throw sticks at me becauseIt was kind of like what we would call a wedding band, you know, soft and gentle and loving. And
フィルは様々な手を尽くしてビリーが捨てようとしていた曲を永遠のヒットチューンへと磨き上げていった。ビリーとバンドはそれまでこの曲をシンプルな8ビートで演奏していた。まずフィルは基本となるリズムを変えた。
I came from working with Brazilian music early in my career, and because of that I understood other rhythms, and it's a combination of a baion and a samba or bossa nova, but not as busy.
バイオンとはブラジルバイア地方の民謡から生まれたダンサブルなリズム。このリズムを取り入れたことでシンプルなロックバラードが見違えるように洗練され魅力的になった。
Even the solo, whichI didn't use the saxophone player at that time in the band. It was hard to explain to him that we needed an alto versus a tenor sax. Alto was more ethereal, Phil Woods, great jazz player. I often mixed jazz with Billy.
間奏のサックスパートはバンドのフィーリングにマッチさせるため、6つのテイクを録音し、それらを一つに編集して作られた。この曲が持つ微妙なニュアンスを形にするためにできる限りの工夫が凝らされていった。
The sound that you hear, and it almost feels like a chorus. We loved a record that was made by 10cc, and it was a series of how the notes would play, and we tried a sort of an unusual overlapping of his voice.So eventually we could actually play the samples, but I did it literally by singing as long as he could sing a note, then back it up and then punch it so that the note would go on and on and on. So it would last at least a minute, each note of the scale, the root, the third, the fifth, and the octave. And that put us in a place where when you turn this up, because it was recorded, I could...Give it this very eerie. And I put this little famous little stone phaser, it was called, on the sound of the Fender Rhodes. And that changed the feeling of the record instead of just.The piano. He loved Fender Rhodes, but he had never really played it with this phase generator. It's what it is. And it set off the music differently. So it wasn't sweet upon sweet, you know?
Fender Rhodes was 1960年代からフェンダー社が売り出したエレクトリックピアノの名機。その独特の音色が人気を博し、電気ピアノの代名詞にもなっている。
First of all, here we are 30 years later. That's an important part of history in the sense that, you know, nothing that we ever do, at least in my world, is something that you think is going to last for a long, long time because you're very young when you're making it.
Don't go changing to try and please me. You never let me down before. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore. I would not leave you in times of trouble. We never could have come this far. I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, I'll take you just the way you are. Don't go trying some new fashion. Don't change the color of your hair. You always have my unspoken passion, although I might not seem to care. I don't want clever conversation, never want to work that hard. I just want someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are.